This is the next question we have, where we have 1,2-dibromobutane. It reacts with KOH alcoholic and NaNH2 in liquid ammonia. So what will happen here? Students, elimination will take place. There are 2 Br atoms attached to this molecule. So 2 molecules of HBr will be removed and alkyne will be formed. Let us see what reaction will be taking place. Here we have CH3, CH2, CHBr, CH2Br. Here we are using alcoholic KOH and then NaNH2. So HBr will be released from here and HBr will be released from here also, giving us butane. This is the butane formed here. Now let's go through the options. We can see the correct answer is given in option 1 only. Now let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says the aldehydes which will not form Grignard product with one equivalent Grignard reagent are. Here we have 4 options, A, B, C and D. Students, we should know that if we have any acidic hydrogen, then one Grignard reagent mole will be converted into alkane. Hence, if I have any acidic hydrogen, in that case, one equivalent will not be sufficient. So here we have benzaldehyde derivatives. The acidic hydrogens are present in option B because here we have COOH group, and in option D where we have alcoholic group. So B and D will not give us Grignard product with one equivalent of Grignard reagent only. Hence, the correct answer for this question will be option 2. Now, let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, for a reaction, consider the plot of natural log K versus 1 upon T given in the figure. If the rate constant of this reaction at 400 Kelvin is 10 to the power minus 5 second inverse, then the rate constant at 500 Kelvin is. This is the graph given, LNK versus 1 upon T. The slope is minus 4606 Kelvin. Now let's find the slope. If I talk about K, it is equals to A e to the power minus E upon RT. So taking log both sides, natural log K will be equal to minus E upon RT plus natural log A. So from here we can simply say that the slope will be equal to minus E upon R. So from here I can write minus E upon R is equals to minus 4606 according to the question given here or slope given here. So from here I can write that EA upon R is equals to 4606. Now we also know that natural log K2 by K1 is equals to EA upon R into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. So from here we can write that natural log K2 by K1 is equals to 4606 into 1 upon 400 minus 1 upon 500. So this will give us ln K2 by K1 is equals to 4606 multiplied by 100 divided by 400 into 500. So from here we can write log base 10 K2 by K1 is equals to 4606 by 2000 into 2.303. Why? Because natural log X is equals to 2.303 log base 10 X. On solving it will give us log base 10 K2 by K1 is equals to 1. Or we can simply write that K2 by K1 is equals to 10. So from here we can simply write K2 is equals to 10 times of K1. And the value of K1 is given 10 to the power minus 5. So it is 10 into 10 to the power minus 5 or 10 to the power minus 4. So if I go through the options, we can see option 4 is the correct answer. Now let's move to the next question.